गुड मॉर्निंग. गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल. आई एम प्रिया भुगे, वर्किंग एज अ असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन सेंट मार्टिन्स इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज. एंड टुडे वी विल डिस्कस सम प्रोग्रामिंग कंसेप्ट. प्रोग्रामिंग कंसेप्ट. बिफोर स्टार्टिंग दिस टॉपिक वी विल डिस्कस व्हाट इज द यूज ऑफ प्रोग्रामिंग. In engineering, we studied different subjects, software engineering, some programming language, some theory subject, some networking, because in engineering or IT industry, especially or engineering field, we require different fields. First of all, in IT industry or engineering field, different domains are there. Programming domain. Then software management domain. Then testing domain. So guys, this is the programming overview, programming language board. In that, two types of language, imperative, declarative. Imperative, structural programming language, procedural programming language. And declarative, logic and functional. First of all, we will see structural programming language means what? Everyone know, everyone hear SQL, PLSQL, MySQL, okay, NoSQL. Means what exactly? This is the SQL language, that is what the structural programming language. Structural programming language, in that programming, we have to use some queries. We have to do some queries to for command. We have to use for programming. Then procedural language means C. C language. We will see, after first we will discuss what is exactly the overview of programming. Okay? Main type of imperative and declarative. Then we will discuss the different types of languages. Okay? C program is nothing but the procedural language. C programming. Okay? This is the example of procedural programming. Then logic and functional programming. In networking, we have to do encryption, decryption, we have to do some binary operation. Okay? For that purpose, we will use the functional programming and logic programming. Okay? Then now, we will discuss some different type of programming language. Everyone here, C programming, C++ programming, Java, Python, MATLAB, VB.NET, okay? So, different types of programming language. Why we are discussing the programming concept? Because in engineering, whole engineering or after engineering, compulsory we have to do, not compulsory, but if you want to go in IT industry or you have to develop some core, you have to start your own startup in software, particularly in software. For that purpose, everyone should know what exactly the programming and total technology of that programming languages. Okay, so now we will discuss different types of programming languages. C language. First C, then C++, then Java, then .NET.
Application, software application. After integrating that
questionnaire, we have to store all data in database. Okay, this is very important part for any software application. Okay, this is another part. Now we will come on languages. C language. This is as I told you, C is a procedural language. Just we have discussed imperative and declarative, two types of language. Okay, in that imperative language, two types are there. One structural and second is a procedural. In procedural, this is a C programming. C programming specially used for this is procedural. Why we call calling as a procedural language? Because this language is only used for system development. For application development, we can't use this language. Okay, in C language, different language, we can say MATLAB. One assembly language is also there. Assembly language. I will tell you later. First, this is a procedural. C language, I will tell you the use of C language. C language is specially used for the system development. Then C++. Again, some content. This is totally functional development. This is used for functional development. This is also used for functional. But this is for procedure. With system development, we can use specially. This is software development, application development. Both language we can use application development. Again, by using .NET, VB.NET, we can develop easily any application. Okay. And now latest, Python language is there. Okay. Python language is also object-oriented language. Object-oriented language means that total, that four languages, by using that all languages, this is all the object-oriented language. Object-oriented language and procedure-oriented language, I will tell you now the difference between both. Just we discussed procedure-oriented language means C. Procedure-oriented language is only useful for system development, and object-oriented is used for application development. Means what exactly? Thus, in system development means, in C language, we have to use some pattern. Like pointer we can use in C++ easily. C also we can use pointer. But some main concept, some main characteristic we can use easily in object-oriented. Means what? Which main characteristic? First thing, abstract data type. We can say abstraction. This is the main characteristic of object oriented. Then inheritance. Then polymorphism. Then fourth one, exception handling also we can do in that C programming.
Runtime error. Okay, then again in section handling we will discuss
minor block, Kelch block. Okay, then encapsulation means what? Encapsulation is nothing but the binding the data. Data binding, you can say. Data binding. Okay.